Hello, one and all, welcome back to another, I guess, part episode here at RTPR. I just want to give a little bit of clearance, I guess. We did live stream yesterday for about 3 hours, and I've realized that none of the Discord got into the actual video, so I thought instead here at Disneyland Wales, we take a little bit of a tour. We take a tour of what happened yesterday, and in just 30 seconds, you're going to get effectively the opening, the grand opening. It is a little bit of pixelated because there was a lot of lag yesterday, but here is the grand opening of Disneyland Wales.
Welcome everyone to this special day. We're all gathered here today because we're starting a new chapter at this magical place. One place where all of you return simply because you enjoy. And it's that feeling that we're all striving to achieve. And we won't stop because we also enjoy bringing that feeling to our community. I stand with most of the team that achieves this up here. The brilliant management team, development team and cast members that all contribute. I know some of them couldn't make it today, however I'm sure that we'll all show our appreciation to them once they see how many of you guys showed up. For the past 6 months, we've taken every single decision carefully to bring elements to the park that you wanted. But before you enter through these gates to find out what we've created for you, it wouldn't be the same without your favourite friends to take part. Before we begin, I want to give my biggest thank you for all the support, for letting us do what we enjoy for over 6 years. I'm sure the 7th anniversary is going to be amazing. And a massive thank you again to every single person who contributed to make this park what it is.
We'll be right back.
just you know, lot know throughout the stream, throughout this recording session, I should say, I'll bring in some stuff that you might have missed on the stream, including some never-before-seen concept of different attractions and also some old things. So this is going to be a pretty long episode, I'll say, but I do want to get through as much stuff as we can because, of course, we streamed for 3 hours and the Discord just didn't decide to record any of it. But we're here. This is on the private server. Michael might join in for a little bit later. I don't know. I messaged him about it. So, if you look, it's already very much different. We have this entire new... I'm going to lower the SOG. But we have an entirely new area here. Oops. That's the one thing I didn't want to do. We have an entirely new area here at Disneyland Wales. Now, there's a car parking, which is pretty cool. It's very, different, obviously, right? We have the normal main street here. So we have our train station, which is very reminiscent of that of the Disneyland version. And just taking a look at these signs here. The El Capitan Theater. With, it looks like it's very mini. Is showing that's a show from Tokyo Disneyland. And let's see, there's Discovery Land, which doesn't look like it's been changed. The castle as well, looking like that has not been changed as well. So we have the Main Street train station. Of course, at one point they did have a train station in the early shots, but now it's the original, kind of like the one at Disneyland and the Disneyland Wales. So we'll go under. Let's go underneath now. Here we have the quote by Disney. Here you leave today and enter a world of yesterday, tomorrow, and fantasy. Wow. My volume was at 100%. I'm just going to lower that now. But, we got some stuff here. So we have Halloween. We have a lot of bit of like castle decorations. Welcome to Dreams. And we arrive here. Inside of Main Street, USA. And there's a lot of stuff here that's very interesting. We have this right here, the Main Street Fire Station. Of course, a little fire post here that serves as a meet and greet section. We have the Park Perks store over there. We have the Emporium. We have the Town Hall. This is all very, very nice and detailed. There's a mix-up of classic Disney with Welsh buildings. Just looking at the Imperium, that's a really nice, like, British, with the bricks and everything. It's very, like, British, very Welsh created. It looks like something it would be at, like, Mr. Toad Wild Ride, for example, at Disneyland. That's a very brick-like structure, very, very English, I guess you could say. There's also over here the original statues. So these original statues would have been here since the park opened. They've seen different textures. The original gold texture was first, and then now they're in a more silver-like, which is very cool to see. And of course, the other side here, with a big inclusion now on wheelchairs and strollers. Be very interesting. Can I sit in one of these? That'd be really, like, that'd be cool if you could take these around with you. Alright, but let's head into now Main Street USA. So, right now, it says it's midnight. I think the time is all over the place right now. I have the, like, actual, like, schedule. Like, what is considered to be midnight? What happens? But the time is a very interesting thing. Because, well, it's not the true time. It's one day in Disneyland Wales is now 4 hours in real life. Which means in 4 hours you can enjoy your stay here at Disneyland Wales with a lot of exciting activities. And those activities can now be found here in this little thing. When this pops up, we get a new GUI, and on calendar, it tells you the show times in the game. So we have It's Magical, which shows twice during the four... Oh. Okay, that's freaky. I think it's... Okay. I think they're still trying to figure it out, because right now, my time says midnight, and it looks like it just changed, but we'll talk about that. So at Magical, it's Magical, which is at Cartoon Corner, it's at 10, and it looks like 12:30 in the morning. We have the 100 Years of Magic Parade, which is at 1 p.m., the Spark Imagination Fireworks Spectacular, which is at 9, the Captain Mickey Splash Spectacular, which is at 3 in the morning, and then another option here at Storybook Circus, Storybook Castle, I should say, which is coming soon, which I think will be the stage show. In terms of other things that are here, there's a map that is not loaded in yet. There's an information tab which talks about like different things and the game passes you can get. You have the autographs tab, which has a bunch of autographs that I don't have. I don't have any autographs. There's an inventory list where you can get your codes. You can get like emblems and things. We'll get to that. There's a codes tab, so it can be found on all social media platforms. There's also this new thing called Party. So you can join friends at the park by selecting. If they're already at the park, you can select them to come in and have fun. And then there are settings. Pronouns, which are always important. The hide and show name tags. But there's also this new thing called Field of View. Right now, it's set to 70. It's default. But if I go, let's say, at 30, and I, like, zoom in, now my field of view is much different. It goes up here, but now this is my field of view at 30 frames. Basically, my frame view at 30, which is really, really cool. I like this whole like frame thing. You get some really cool like cinematic shots. You get like the really, really cool like cinematic shots if you're doing it in this setting, which I really, really like. I think it's really, really cool. But we'll get out of this one. We'll go back to the normal default. Well, let's go back to 30. To exit out, you have to click this button. So. Oops. That one's supposed to be there. Whatever, it's fine. So let's continue, shall we? We have the parks and the park perks, balloons, and wands. So there's a lot of interesting stuff here. Obviously, the park perks and everything. You get the plushies, but there's also these stuff. If you look on the bottom right-hand corner, I have a dollar sign. It says 110. I should have a lot more, but I don't. Each one of these are hats. They cost 1,000. The golden ears cost 1,000. The Pixwell ears cost $500. You have ponchos, which are about 100. You have these as well, which are 1,000. Or there's a lot. All these plush are now cost in-game value. And how you get these values by doing one or two things. You either go on the rides and have a great time, or there's this daily wheel spin. Let's see. I have about an hour before I have to do it again. Okay, I gotcha. Then we have the Emporium on the other side, which is a merchandising line. So we can head in there. So here's the Emporium. You get some. Look at this. You get like snow globes. That's cool. Can I get a snow globe? Or how does that work? I guess it won't let me get a snow globe. That's a little mean. Though I feel like those snow globes and those mugs would be kind of cool. Maybe I'll put one of those mugs in like the interview section. That would be kind of cool. Anyway, let's continue. Oh, something was wrong. Didn't work. And then the other thing here to note of importance in the Main Street area is the Red Dragon Cafe and the Munchies Bakery. They both made their return, so you can get some Mickey pretzels, some Mickey cookies, Mickey stuff. And then, of course, here at the Red Dragon Cafe, you can go up to the second floor, and you can. It's like a nice little dining area here, which is pretty cool. And I think, what is this? Cast members only? That's not me. So I'll head back down. And then the last stop here is, of course, the beautiful castle, the new castle hub that is getting a big renovation, and the Mickey statue and the castle. Very, very cool to see. Now, should mention, there are technically only 4 theme lands. The 5th theme land, which was Berry Harbor, got cut, which is, to me, I love that Berry Harbor got cut, because it was only there as a nighttime entertainment spot for the Captain Mickey Splash Spectacular. So, We're going to start in Adventureland, and we'll go from there. So normally here would be the entrance to go into Berry Harbor. Of course, now that does not exist. So let's go into Adventureland first. And in Adventureland, nothing has really changed, I would say. The only new thing that has happened here at Adventureland is that they finally opened up Jungle Cruise to the public. But that's about it. So everything is pretty much the same. You have the Safari Outpost. You have the Magic Carpets of Aladdin. Is that what what's that in the distance over here? That's new. We'll get to that eventually. I think I know what that is, but we'll get to it eventually. We have the volcano, which still is here. That's a surprise. The volcano still made it. You have Tarzan over there in the background. I love the audio change of music. It's pretty cool. Yeah, there's definitely a castle back there. You have Tarzan. Tarzan the Adventure, which got a little bit of a facelift, but still looks very cool, I will admit. Of course, we did Tarzan for Theme Park Overview. It's a good score. And I love this, the having the wheelchairs and the strollers all around the park. It's very, very cool. The other thing that is just open to the public now, if you have not know this, Jungle Cruise. Jungle Cruise has been in development for 5 years now, has finally opened to the public. I got to ride it yesterday. It was an okay ride. I thought it was okay. We're going to do a theme park overview episode when Belle gets back from his trip. We're going to do a theme park overview episode on the Jungle Cruise. There'll be a little bit of time for that one, just because Belle is going to be away for a little while. The other exciting thing that they added here at Adventureland is the Captain Mickey Splash Spectacular. So this is now where Captain Mickey Splash Spectacular will be. As you can tell, there is no stage. So they'll all be on the boats. And I've heard from Michael it is a little bit longer. They added in an extra song, effectively. And it's a song of Goofy and Max. So Max will make his Disneyland Wales entertainment debut with an all new boat, an all new ship, and a couple people. I've heard that Minnie, Donald, and Mickey are also coming with new ships to sail upon the ocean sea, so it should be interesting to see what ends up happening there. So it looks like the time is very much off, because right now it looks like it's in the daytime, and for me the time says it's zero, so we could have something maybe pop up, maybe during this small recording we get a 100 years of magic, so we'll head over there and watch it if we're lucky. All right, so the next theme land is Fantasy Valley, or otherwise known as Not Fantasy Land. And Fantasy Valley definitely got an expansion. Fantasy Valley was one of those places that just didn't have a lot. It had maybe one or two, and had Merida's Brave Adventure, and it had the Mad Tea Party. But now, it's gotten a little bit more of a facelift. And at this new area, all the way over here, you still have the Night Delight, which does show up from time to time. But now you have this entire new subland, which, if you remember, this particular subland was how you got into Merida's Brave Adventure. And then there was another little quarter. You had the Mad Tea Party here. You had Merida's Brave Adventure all the way at the end, and then you had a little quarter for stuff coming soon. This would have been that facelift. So they have the new Fantasy Valley Royal Theater, which is rumored to be a stage show of some sort. I was originally thinking it could be like something like Mickey and the Magical Map, but I've been told it is a stage show of some sort. We also then have the four famous attractions, the coming soon to the public, The Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh, which we've seen at Rapa multiple times. That is, of course, coming to Fantasy Valley. And then the two newest attractions coming to Fantasy Valley. The first one, Beauty and the Beast. According to Michael himself, this is going to be a dark ride. So very reminiscent of the enchanting tales of Beauty and the Beast at Tokyo Disneyland, with a little bit of a custom setting, of course, being a dark ride show. The other one, all the way over here, we have the Journey to the Center Nope. Journey. What is the term? We have the Ariel's Undersea Adventure. That's what it is. Which will also be a dock ride, very reminiscent to the one in real life, the Omni Mover dock ride system. About Ariel and her undersea adventure. So that should be also a really, really fun attraction to see. You still have Manita's Brave Adventure over here as well. We did a theme park overview episode on that one as well. It's still there. But also now here, and I'm very excited for this one, Disneyland Wales has finally released the Alice in Wonderland maze. Jumping into a bit of history with this one. When Disneyland Wales was just starting to become relevant, we had finished WALL-E, and we were working on the second attraction, which was Mickey Mouse in a Haunted House. At that particular point in time, we knew we wanted to do a theme park of some sort. We had Moana building, we had Hunchback of Notre Dame that we were starting up, we had a Frozen ride we were starting up. We wanted to do more and more attractions. And we had, when we originally wanted to do the park, we always wanted to have an Alice in Wonderland maze. And we were working also on an Alice in Wonderland dock ride, very reminiscent to the one in Disneyland. Seeing the maze come back for the first time since myself and Michael were building it on studio a few years back, it is a sight to see. This will also probably be doubled. We'll do a theme park episode with Alice in Wonderland maze and also with the Mad Tea Party. We'll do a two-in-one eventually on that one, but I'm super excited that they brought back the maze. I truly am. Alright, two lands left to go, and we head into the world of tomorrow. We land into the world of Discovery here in Discovery Land. So they updated Discovery Land a little bit, right? This recently got updated before anything happened, right? We've seen the new Odin structure. We've seen the Black Hole Space Mountain structure, but they've added in one distinct area, and it's back here. It's the Autotopia. Or otherwise known as the Tomorrowland Speedway. For them, they added in the Autotopia, which is kind of a slow-moving car ride through various things. And they added the People Mover to also go back there as well. So both the People Mover and the Autotopia go back there. So no longer does the People Mover now run through various areas like WALL-E and like Mission Space Black Hole. What is it called? Space Mountain, the Mission Black Hole. Now, they still do the jetpack stuff, so don't be afraid if that went away. They still do it. There are times where the cast members, even though all of the shows now are automatic, like the parade is automatic and everything, there are still times where cast would come onto the public servers and there would be Disney characters that could come out, you get their autograph signed, or these cavalcades or jetpacks. It's a very cool thing to see. Space Mountain, Mission Black Hole got a little bit of a facelift, not much. And of course the other attraction, whoops, over here, we're headed to Cartoon Corner in a moment. You look at the entrance over here, it's very reminiscent to Tomorrowland entrance with the with this bulb kinda, right? This very reminiscent of Disneyland, but Walt Disney World's Tomorrowland, with the rocks kind of coming out, and of course going straight down is a rocket ship with Space Mountain and Mission Black Hole. The last one that needs to be talked about is all the way tucked back here is WALL-E the ride. So WALL-E the ride is currently under construction and will be released to the public, I heard, within the next year. I've heard that WALL-E the ride will come out to the public within the next year. So either this year or next year, WALL-E the ride, WALL-E the adventure will return to Disneyland Wales. All right. The last area that's left on the docket is the new and improved Cartoon Corner. Every single theme land got a refresh. It wasn't just one land that got a refresh. They all got one. In fact, Berry Harbor left. So we have Cartoon Corner now, which definitely got a facelift. Whole new street. We still have the Mickey House and the Fantasia Gardens. But we now have two new things. We have the Cartoon Corner Town Hall, which is very reminiscent of the one in real life. And we also have the El Capitan Theater, which will house It's Very Mini, which is a Tokyo Disneyland show. So it will not be Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. Instead, it will be It's Very Mini from Tokyo Disneyland. Eventually, I feel like they will do something like cartoon Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. Maybe. But right now, it will be a show. Sorry to get everyone's hopes up. Final small little area here, we have It's Magical. Right, so It's Magical. It's from the Tokyo Disneyland 10th anniversary show called It's Magical, which is basically what happens if you take a show like Fantasmic and you put it on a castle stage. And that's what they did at Tokyo Disneyland. And then when creating Disneyland Wales, we wanted to bring a sense of magic into the air. And we weren't going to do Fantasmic, so we might as well do something that is very reminiscent of Fantasmic, that being It's Magical. The final little area here, we have Memory Lane with two distinct attractions. We have the Mickey Mouse and a Haunted House attraction with a new Haunted House facelift. I don't like this. I don't like this. I liked the old one that was cartoonish-like. I'm a little mad about that. I'm also mad because Charlie Troubles is still here and it has a sign saying it's closing. And I don't like that at all. Charlie Troubles Roller Coaster, one of the last things that I had project led in terms of attractions at Disneyland Wales. I'm a little mad about this, but I don't know if it's a going away type thing or if it's going to be staying and they're just doing a refresh. I don't know. I'm still not happy about it, I will admit. So we'll get out of here. And we'll head back to the main park now. We have the El Capitan Theater. So the other interesting thing that they've added is this little area here. So when fireworks shows happen, like Spark Your Imagination, there is a Cartoon Corner Spectacular Sights fireworks spot. Now it is a game pass, but it does give you a really, really cool view of the castle and everything, so that's a little bit of a plus. So if you're in the mood and want to get one of those, you can. But we'll get out of Cartoon Corner here and back to the main server. So I'm not gonna do my own review on this. If I was to review this entire facelift, I would probably give it an 8 out of 10, but that's not what I'm here for. What I'm really, really here for is just to show you guys the exciting future that Disneyland Wales has up in store. We saw the stuff with the Beauty and the Beast ride, the Ariel ride, the unfortunate closures of both Wally and Oswald, but hopefully they become much more bigger in the future. Jungle Cruise has opened up to the public. Man of the Big Adventure is still here. It's Magical is back. Spark Imagination got a small facelift to include more effects and everything. The inclusion of NPC automatic parades, I think, is a big hit. The parade is called 100 Years of Magic Parade, which is also from, believe it or not, Tokyo Disneyland. So there's a lot of Tokyo, there's a lot of Paris in here, but it's also a lot of custom stuff with the stuff like Tarzan the Adventure, Man of the Brave Adventure, the Mission Black Hole, Odin, which is... There's going to be a theme park overview episode coming up at some point, but we went on to Odin to the Center of the Earth, and I talked about, effectively that, it about all the history, with that being an original story, and all the different versions that park, that attraction went through. So, I'm very, very excited to see what happens next. But, coming up next, and I will show at least one of the videos off, is the first. Now, I believe I am the only one with this audio file, with this video file at hand. But when Disneyland Wales was first being developed, and I'm talking first being developed, back, we opened the park in 2018. In 2016, when we were starting Disneyland Wales. We opened up Wally first. We did Mickey Mouse and Haunted House. We did Moana. Those were the first big three. After Moana, that's when Michael and I had decided that we were going to build a actual theme park. With later down the road, having multiple attractions come out, like Journey to the Center of the Earth, like Oswald's Trolley Troubles. And then stuff that just didn't end up happening. Like, for example, a Enchanted Tiki Room Dining Shop. Or the first expansion called Neverland, which would have had Treasure Planet, Peter Pan, Pirates of the Caribbean. We had ideas to do a Beauty and the Beast ride, which obviously something similar like that is coming to the park. We had ideas to do Hunchback. We had ideas to do Lion King, Jungle Book. The whole list goes. It was a very, very long. Monsters, Inc. was involved. It was a very, very long list. And even Frozen and Alice. We had a lot of things that we wanted to do. And a lot of it didn't end up happening. Just because we got burnt out every single time we went to one of those attractions that we wanted to do. And we started. And we never finished it. To see some of those ideas now reforming in this new era of Disneyland Wales, I love that. I think it's really, really cool to see. Especially some of Beauty and the Beast and Ariel. Jungle Cruise is out. Go check out Jungle Cruise. Seeing small creations of mine like Wall-E or Oswald's Trolley Troubles get a big facelift out of it. I will be sad seeing the originals gone, but I hope that the refurbishment and the nuances they bring back will be very, very good. And speaking of the video, coming up right now is a never-before-seen version of the first-ever show we did for Disneyland Wales. The oldest castle we ever did, which was the Bloxy Castle. Small 2-minute video of Disneyland Wales performing It's Magical for the very first time. Enjoy!
Annaur Magical.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, thank you everyone for tuning in to this, I would say this mini stream. I don't know, it's going on for about 30 minutes, so I feel like that's about a time. I streamed for 2 hours, and there was a lot of stuff said, but Coming soon, I am going to do an interview with Michael very soon, and we'll talk about the Disneyland Wales, a little bit of the history, but also we'll jump into everything new for the 7th anniversary, what things will be coming soon. But until that interview happens, I've been Joe, you've been watching RTPR, and I'll catch you guys in the next episode. Have a good one.